I bought a 3D printer and I'm very excited to make this unboxing video, assemble it and start making parts for my passive knitting machine. So this will be the topic of today's video as well as my first step in my 3D printing journey. First, let's see what there is inside the box. On top I can see a bag with instructions. Then there is another bag with some tools and screws to assemble the printer. This is my first 3D printer, so at the moment when the video was shot I didn't know almost anything about it. This is the power cord. Next I took out the spool holder and the screen. This is the metal stand for the spool holder and the filament sensor which is attached to it. Then we can take out the gantry. And the last thing in the box is the base of the printer. I managed to get it out of the box after a bit of struggling. There is nothing more inside the box, so I will move it to the side and I will show you the small parts up close. This is the first bag that I took out of the box. Inside it there is a metal tool that is used to clean the nozzle. Then there is a quick installation guide, a warranty card and a sticker. Now let's see what's inside the second bag. The first thing inside the bag is 20 meters of white PLA filament. Then we can see many small parts in the different packages. The small tube is full of grease for the printer. I can also see that there is a USB drive included with the printer. In this bag there are some wrenches, a screwdriver and some Allen keys. Inside this cardboard packaging there are the cutters which we will use to cut the filament. They are super cute. In one of the small packages I saw that there was a spare nozzle included. Now let's clean this mess and assemble the printer. At first I will mount the gantry to the base. On the left side there is a small cable which you have to push through the hole on the printer. This cable will come out from the bottom and I will connect it a bit later. Align the gantry with the slots and push it down. Now on the back side of the printer there is a short cable that has to be connected to the motor of the gantry. The long cable that is coming from the base has to be connected to the motor on the top and the widest part must be connected to the printer's head. At first I will insert the part with the label in the metal bracket. Now I will turn the printer and connect the cable to the printer's head. First slide the plastic clips on the sides of the printer's head. Make sure the cable is coming below the top frame of the gantry. Now insert it in the socket. Push it down until the plastic clips are closed. Now I will put the printer to its side. On the right side we have to screw 3 screws to fix the gantry to the base. We have to use one of the Allen keys to tighten them securely. You can now see the screws. Now I will turn the printer to its other side. First take out the cable that we put through the hole in the base of the printer and connect it to the short cable that is already inside that hole. Now we have to insert 3 screws in the holes and tighten them to fix this side of the gantry. After the screws are tightened securely, push the cable back into the hole. Now take the small package that contains 3 screws. Take the screen and the holder and connect the cable to the screen. I thought that the screen couldn't be detached from the holder, but that's not true. I put the printer on its side again, then inserted all screws into the holes, and now I will use one of the Allen keys to tighten the screws. If I had known that the screen could be detached from the holder, this procedure would have been faster. You have to put 2 additional screws to fix the gantry to the base. They are on the right side of the printer, or in other words, the side where the screen is. Please don't forget to support me by liking the video and leaving me a comment below. Now let's mount the spool holder. The filament sensor must be positioned at the bottom towards the front of the printer. The metal holder is mounted to the top of the gantry using 2 screws. Now take the spool holder and mount it as shown in the video. The spool should be placed on the front of the printer, so make sure the holder is sticking towards the front. Take the short cable from the top of the gantry and connect it to the filament sensor. The last thing is to fix the cable to the printer's head by using the small plastic part and the 2 screws which are left in one of the packages. I forgot to do that at the right moment. This is the spare nozzle. It is the only part left. All of the screws are mounted. I don't know what brand is the USB stick, but on the site I saw that it has 16 GB of memory. Don't forget to remove all insulating materials before turning on the printer. Check if the voltage switch is set to the right voltage, then plug the power cord and turn on the printer. First, I have to select the language. Now I have to accept the terms of use. And I can now connect the printer to my Wi-Fi network, which I will do because I like the idea of sending the G-code to the printer remotely. Now we have to enter the time zone. I'm not sure why I should enter the time zone, but sometimes it's better when you don't know. Now we can connect the printer to the mobile app, which I will also make. After everything is set, the printer will start performing its initial test. It will heat up the nozzle, self-align the bed and run some other checkups. Now the test is finished and I can insert the filament. You can manually heat up the nozzle and insert the filament or use the automatic option in the menu. The nozzle is heating up pretty fast. The guys from the store told me to start with white filament so I can easily see if the first layer is correctly stuck to the bed until I get used to the printer. I will put the spool on the holder, then I will cut the filament at 45 degrees using the small cutters. At first, I have to put the filament through the sensor. Then I have to push and hold the release lever and feed up the filament until I get some of it squeezed on the bed. You can also use the automatic feed option from the menu. Use tweezers to remove the waste. Now let's insert the USB stick in one of the slots. There is a Benchy uploaded and it will be my first print. Make sure the calibration box is checked and start the printer. It will automatically level the bed and start printing. If you have connected the printer to the mobile app, you will get a notification when the print is finished. You can also change the settings and send more projects to the printer both from the mobile app and the Creality software that's on your PC. The software is uploaded on the USB stick. The printing is pretty fast, but as you can tell, the video is also sped up. Now the print is finished. And this is the Benchy up close. I will share one additional thing with you. From the settings menu, you can check if you have the latest version of the firmware installed. If there is a red dot, you must update the printer. This will ensure you have a good experience using the printer. It will only take several minutes for the update to be installed, then you will be able to use the printer again. In the description, you can find the link to my account in Thingiverse where I will upload parts that I have designed. Also, I will leave a link to my playlist where I will upload videos related to 3D printing. There will be several tutorials on how I'm designing some of the parts. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and see you in my next video.